Casey O'Neill, along with Dave Cornish, head coach of the now finalist Ledyard High School Colonels, and Philip Thomas, the high scorer in tonight's semifinals. And take this opportunity now, you're playing New London in the finals on Friday night, rematch of the earlier game this season. Now, the first game was all hyped up because it was all about story, right? It was all about New London and Ledyard finally getting together and playing each other, a lot of backstories and all that. I want to throw that all out the window because Friday night is the number one seed versus the number two seed for the ECC championship. From a pure basketball standpoint, where is Ledyard basketball right now?
Well, actually, we'll find out Friday night if we're on top or we're second fiddle.
All right. We were talking about on the broadcast, both teams are contenders in the state tournament race, you and double L, them and L. The difference being that, obviously, Ledyard basketball hasn't won an ECC championship yet either. Is an ECC championship the first hurdle, or is it still about the larger goal?
No, it's actually the first hurdle. We wanted to win the ECC large division, which we accomplished. Our second goal is to win the ECC championship, and then which is the largest goal, you know, is to win the state championship.
So step one is there Friday night. Win or lose, how does that affect what you do moving forward after that?
I mean, we'll pick up the pieces if we lose. We'll pick up the pieces and get ready for the state tournament. It doesn't affect us at all. I mean, we've done it in the past, and we've made great runs in the state tournament. So we'll be fine.
Tonight, I felt like it was a different Ledyard basketball team than what I saw last time when we broadcast the game versus New London. I felt that I saw you guys play much higher energy, many more people involved. From your perspective, leader, a veteran of this team, where do you feel this team is now versus where you were when you lost that close game to New London earlier a month ago?
I think that loss definitely helped us. We had one loss prior to that, but that was definitely because, like you said, like all the hype and like Ledyard New London, and it definitely made us kind of pick up our pieces, and everybody put everything together, put the puzzle pieces together, I guess you could say, and we kind of brought the team together, and I think it's making us play a lot better.
Do you think now, you said in the post game that, you know, you guys took that loss to heart and used it as a means to get better and improve, and do you think now Friday night can be about basketball and not about the fact that it's New London? Do you think Friday night can be about, this is a team that beat you earlier in the season and the best team in the conference, so you guys need to climb that hurdle? Can it be, in other words, can it be just about the game and not about the storylines?
Do I think it can? Yes. Will it be? Probably not, because I think everybody, not including the fans, there's going to be over thousands of people there, plus everybody on the team. Like, I think everybody gets caught up in it, but once it comes down to it and tip-off comes, I think everybody just knows it's just basketball.
Now, what I saw out of you tonight from a basketball standpoint was unlike anything I had seen. Keith O'Brien equated it to the old Arkansas Nolan Richardson's 40 minutes of hell. I equated it to watching a blitz in football. I've never seen four guys attack a basketball. Waterford must have felt like there were eight guys on the floor at certain times. The level of harassment really seemed to be like, we're going to send more guys at you than you can process at one time. Not to give away any secrets, but is there something different about that? That doesn't look like any pressure I had ever seen before.
It's just creating chaos. That's what they call it, chaos. And no, we do that in practice. We'll put seven, eight guys out on you know pressure against our offense and see how they go against it. So we just like to create havoc.
Well, you certainly did that tonight. Now the flip side is when someone's able to break the pressure, easy baskets on the other end. So what's the message that you have to deliver as you go into Friday night against a team like New London, who would seem to have the kind of personnel that can break that pressure? What's the message in a situation like that?
We have to be a little more disciplined on Friday night. You know, we still want to create havoc and make them pass the ball as much as possible, but we also have to be more disciplined in our areas. Tonight we got a little away from that, but we have to be more disciplined, that's all.
First game in your gym, sold out, people being turned away, hot as all get out. and we saw emotions get the best of some of the players. It seemed like the game was bigger than some of the emotions. From a player's standpoint, how do you plan on going into a game as big as this off of what's already happened? How do you stay focused? You're an emotional player, but you always seem to be under control. How do you manage that in a game of this magnitude on Friday?
Like you said, I'm sort of the veteran on this team. So like when I need to help I need to help my teammates more than I need to help myself. So like I just try to bring them together and like keep them calm and keep them knowing like that this is just a basketball game. It's not a 5-on-5 brawl. Like we just need to do what we need to do. Worry about us and don't do anything too overboard.
So number one seed, undefeated, they're ranked. They're where you want to be. The storylines can be just about basketball. There doesn't need to be any of the history to make this a special event on Friday night, because you've got exactly that. You've got a team playing great basketball who has one more hurdle to clear. Now, you came here to Ledyard fully believing that you could turn this into a basketball program that could succeed. You've started to do that. Is the ECC championship a sort of turning point for the Ledyard High School basketball program?
Well, I believe it is. I mean, I don't believe they ever have, you know, they've won an ECC tournament championship. So this would be great, you know, not just for me, but for the senior class and every member of this team, and even the past players that I've coached since I've been here. So, I mean, we're all like a family. Once you're a colonel under my watch, we're all family. So it would be huge for the whole Ledyard family that we have.
Now, I wouldn't normally ask this question, but I think because of your role here, it's relevant. Colin Sawyer just moved past Tommy Poblete. He is now the eighth leading scorer in the history of New London High School. That's a pretty significant achievement. You coached many of those players on that list. From a coaching standpoint, how do you approach someone of that, you know, someone who scores points like that? How do you handle, the eighth all-time scorer in New London High School history?
It won't be easy. I mean, Colin's a great shooter. He's a great shooter. I mean, you can't give him any room. I think we did a decent job on him at our place the first time around, but we have to do a much better job this time around because this is, you know, bigger stakes. It's a bigger game. So we have to do a better job. We have to be more disciplined. Colin, like I said, but he's not the only shooter. You know what I mean? So we have to stay with him and Seth and just not let him go off for 25, 30 points.
Friday night, 5 seconds left in the game. Would you rather have the ball in your hands to shoot the final shot, or would you rather be defending the person who's about to shoot the final shot on the other side of things?
I think I definitely have the ball in my hands. I mean, I don't know. It always feels better when the ball's in your hands. When you're a defender, you never know where he's going to go. He always has the upper hand on you because he has the ball in his hands. You're like his puppet. Like, he does what he wants with you, and he makes you go where he wants to go. So I'd rather have the ball in my hands.
Would you rather have the ball in his hands the way he played tonight?
Absolutely. If this Phillip Thomas shows up, absolutely.
Well, we asked in the pregame who was going to be that second player. We know that Deontay's always going to score. We know that he's always going to be the catalyst. When you guys have that second person, and, you know, Mario Graham was one of the top 10 scorers in the ECC this year, quietly, because he's the second leading scorer. But you play like you did tonight. You have a second scorer, or tonight, in this case, a leading scorer. I mean, this becomes a whole different basketball team.
Oh, yeah, it does. I mean, we need Phillip. Mario averaging 17. Deontay's averaging 24. We need Phillip to be averaging 16, 17, at least close to 20 points a night. So we'll be really tough, tougher to guard.
So my last question for you, Phillip, is that you had some big guys on the floor tonight, but not like what you're going to see on Friday night. Brian Cespedes, who wasn't in the game as much in that first matchup, Major Roman, two very big bodies. Plus, New London has sort of overall length at all the positions. What do you need to do on Friday night? What's the thing that you need to bring to the table Friday night to be as effective in that game as you were in a game like tonight?
I don't think it's much different tonight. Just keep getting the ball in the middle, keep going to the hole hard. I mean, you can't really do much for shot blockers besides up fake. And I noticed most of the time when we were playing them, most of them didn't go for it because they don't really get off the floor. They just have, like, they're long, like you said. So just go to the hole hard.
One message that you're going to tell your team tomorrow at practice.
That's a secret.
Yeah, I tried. Dave Cornish, the head basketball coach of Ledyard High School, Philip Thomas, the senior leader and leading scorer in tonight's semifinals. Thank you for joining us. We'll be broadcasting you live on Friday night. Good luck.